school in T-minus 30.
Yeah, I'm up.
No, I'd rather eat snots and Brian Corbel in his class.
Yeah, I'm not up.
I love rabbits!
I don't care what I look like today.
My stat homework in bio, my AP Gov test in drama. Oh, and then I'm gonna print out my homework in the library during lunch.
Oh, only 95 days until graduation.
Is that all?
Hey, Mom, I think I might be sick.
Stay down or I will shear you like a sheep.
Hey.
Hey.
What's good?
Hair.
Love you.
Love you more.
Mom, my neurology is like pink now. It's freaking ruined.
Xander, I did it the same way I always do it.
Well, you ruined it, so F your birthday dinner. Now I gotta buy a new shirt. I freaking love rabbits.
Hey, nobody's watching.
I am.
The Declaration of Independence was written on... Hello? Polly, your pancakes are on the table. And your lunch bag is in your backpack. I washed your Batman shirt. It's on your dresser. Your checklist is on the fridge. And remember to count to 50 in your head for your freshman routine. Try not to wake up Mom, okay? I love you.
Houston, prepare for boredom. Escape pod ready to launch at 1500 hours.
Rabbits!
You are such an amazing person, and everyone needs to know this fact.
Who are you talking to?
You got this. You want to hear it? I love my life.
Affirmations about it.
Can you turn that down?
No.
Oh, now you want to go out with me. Beg.
Yeah, that's it. Beg for mercy.
AR-15, biatch.
On July 4th, 1776, in Philadelphia, the United States of America, that's lowercase united, capital states, capital America, this ratified the Declaration of Independence. Now, it's pretty long, and a lot of it is talking about their grievances against King George III, so I'm just going to stick to the most famous part. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Not gonna touch their creator because this is public school, and men? Well, when they say men, they kind of mean white men who own lands, so I'm just gonna stick to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. This phrase was written by Thomas Jefferson, the third president of the United States and considered one of the founding fathers. I will be discussing it in reverse order. So no one's 100% certain what Jefferson meant when he wrote In the Pursuit of Happiness in 1776. Nowadays, when we think happiness, we're like, I'm happy! I'm happy!
Yeah.
But back in the day, it meant something else. Or maybe something else. Some define happiness as property, aka individual prosperity, aka having a lot of stuff. In fact, as claims sources in my bibliography, that George Mason originally wanted to use property, but that Thomas Jefferson substituted In the Pursuit of Happiness on the advice of Benjamin Franklin. Ben Franklin, not just for flying kites and inventing bifocals. But here's the other thing. Pursuit at the time didn't mean chasing after something like a car chase. There weren't cars, duh. But instead, practicing it. So you weren't entitled to chase happiness, but to practice happiness. So that brings us back to, what is happiness? It's not just being rich.
But according to Professor Brent Strong at Emory University, it's about flourishing. Flourishing means having access to things like food, health, and safety, and maybe helping other people get those things too. Maybe.
Everybody, come in the store. Where we are, and then we need
ambulance. I'm sure there's something hate a lot of them.
Yeah, but they don't know anyone here. We're in the room 104.
This girl got hit.
Talia got hit. We need an ambulance.
There's a lot of blood.
Room 104. We need help.
Hurry. There's so much blood. I love you.
Love you.
I love you.
Talia, you got this.
We're all here. How do you stay so much between the crap ton of blood all over the floor? I wish I had a hero switch because unhero me is so scared if I open my mouth, she's going to hear my fear, and then I don't think she's going to make it. Maybe that would kill her. I also think keeping it closed will be the only thing holding the moment now.
Is that Aviana?
What do we do?
Okay, does anybody know CPR?
What's CPR gonna do for a bullet hole?
I'm sorry, that was stupid.
It's okay.
Harry?
They made me put pressure on.
How is there no first aid kit?
It's gotta be here somewhere.
Hey, Talia. It's Lola. You sit in front of me in English, and I don't know if you know that I look over your shoulder, or like peek, but your drawings are kind of amazing. At first I think you're taking notes, then I think you're just doodling, and it's like, wow, she's doing all these anime versions of the characters from whatever books we're reading. Medusa in the Odyssey, the creepy half-naked boys from Lord of the Flies, the way you worked the red eye into your Hester friend. I had to pretend I was choking on my gum to keep you from finding out I was fine. I just didn't want you to stop. When you get better, I swear, first thing I'm gonna do is tell you how much I love them.
Shooter, last seen leaving the cafeteria and may be near the gymnasium. Do not engage unless necessary. Emergency response team arriving imminently. Continue to shelter in place and send all updates through the emergency messaging system.
Please let me get out of this.
Please let me make it.
Please don't let me die.
Please.
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 If I live, I will never talk back to my mom again. I promise not to pay attention.
I will laugh at my grandpa's jokes even if I don't understand them.
I'll do my chores while being
asked. I'm not here to superintend.
Okay, quit making fun of that kid with the stutter or anybody.
I'll never pretend that I'm too busy for family dinner.
I will never put diamond in body cereal or pee in a cup and tumble and saddle juice. I'm not proud of that or short to use that or kidnapping Sydney, even if he ratted me out to mom for breaking curfew. And even if 9 is way too old for Seth Wallace cleverly named after a major Australian city or not, I will never be that sibling again. Just give me a break here, okay?
I will try to be nicer.
I will be a better son.
I'll be a better daughter.
I'll be somebody that you can be proud of.
Just let me make it out of today alive.
After Parkland? No matter what channel you were on. You kept seeing all those stories about those teachers who were total heroes. I mean, they literally died for their students. And that's amazing. But I came here to student teach math. For 9 weeks, I need it for my certification. I started yesterday. And now I'm supposed to die for you? No offense, but I think I know like 3 of your names so far. You. You got a 5 out of 5 on the pop quiz, so I guess I'd die for you. You. You had a good answer for that question about the angles of an isosceles triangle, so maybe you too. But you. And maybe you're totally great, but so far you haven't participated at all. And I could see you drawing a dog peeing on a fire hydrant while that girl with the purple hair was explaining sine and cosine at the whiteboard. I've seen better peeing dogs. But it's only been 2 days. Not even 2 days. And who knows, maybe 9 weeks from now you'll be my favorite student. Probably not, though. You know, I kind of just thought I'd see how I liked teaching. Worst case scenario, maybe end up with food poisoning once or twice from what appears to be your less than stellar cafeteria food. I didn't think I'd have to consider whether or not I'd take your bullet today. Maybe I should have. I mean, seriously, though, I'm 5 years older than you. I've got almost as much life ahead of me. Probably more than some of you with all that processed crap you eat. I guess what I'm saying is, please don't think any less of me if I don't go your way on this one.
This is Ariane Williams from Vulture TV News, and I am in room 328. This was the nearest doorway when I first heard shots fired. I am in a classroom with 10 other students, I think. Yes, 10. There are no teachers. This is Ms. Haybury's room. She was at lunch. I don't have a definite number of how many people have been shot, but I've been told that there are over a dozen. Let me say that these numbers have not been confirmed. The shooter is a teenage male, and that is all I can confirm at this time.
What are you recording?
I'm doing a story for Vulture TV. The last official announcement said that the emergency response team is arriving imminently. But as of right now, we are waiting for further updates.
I knew this was going to happen.
You know who the shooter is?
No, nothing like that.
Then how did you know it was going to happen?
I just did.
Did you hear something? Did you see somebody
close? It's happening everywhere else, and nobody's doing anything. Why wouldn't it happen here? I didn't want to come today. Or most days. Better odds. You know? But my mom made me. I guess she's gonna feel like crap now.
This is Ariane Williams of Vulture TV.
Do you think every other classroom is just like this?
Like
what? Waiting! I just wish he'd come in and get it over with
no,
already.
No, don't. Try to think of something else.
I'm trying, but every time I close my eyes, my brain imagines him opening the door over and over again.
Maybe if you say it out loud. Try.
It's 10 years from now. Maybe 15 or 20 tops. I'm a musical legend.
Nice.
Well, maybe not a legend, but I'm a pretty big deal. I mean, having a number one album in a row will do that to you. So this is the part of the show where I thank you all for coming out and for always giving my music love, even when I was performing high school cafeterias. Alright, well this next song goes out to my high school sweetheart and the world's most amazing wife, Cora.
Woo! Woo! Oh, bucket list, baby!
There's a bucket? Where? I'm gonna do it!
Don't be such a drama queen. You'll be fine.
We are 15,000 feet in the air! How do you know I'll be fine?
We've been through worse than this.
True story.
Or if you really don't want to jump.
I don't want to. But we promised.
It's the 12th grade promises.
12th grade promises. Woo!
My high school biology teacher, Mrs. Dorothea Rubin, was literally the only woman in our science department. And before I had her, I thought that science was just something that men did. But then I discovered it wasn't. That women can play with mitochondria and protoplasm and chromosomes too. Cancer, your days are numbered, and for that, thank you, Ms. Rubin.
My turn. I would like to announce my candidacy for President of the United States.
I'm going to be a civil rights attorney.
Firefighter!
CEO of my own amazing company.
What will it do?
Amazingness!
I'm going to walk on Mars.
I'm going to mentor at-risk kids.
And I'm going to dance. And everyone will be watching.
Liberty. We all know what liberty means, but you kind of have to wonder what Jefferson was thinking when he wrote Liberty in 1776. Jefferson had slaves. In fact, every colony had slaves. Some like Virginia and South Carolina had more, and others like Massachusetts and Rhode Island had less. Fewer. But they still had them. Not a lot of liberty for those folks. And by 1776, they made up nearly 20% of the population. That's one out of every five people. I was going to do one of those cool demo things where I had people stand up and move to different sides of the classroom, but I was worried I'd go over time. So, since there are 25 of us in here, you five in the back, slaves. But there was also this kind of person called an indentured servant. And there were a lot of them in the 13 colonies. Nearly half of everyone who came over from Europe at the time of the American Revolution. Yeah, I had no idea about that either. An indentured servant wasn't a slave. Well, not exactly, but they were for a while until they worked off their trip to America. It could be a year or as long as 7 years. That's middle school and high school put together. Though the average was more around 3 years, that's still a long time. You were given food and a place to sleep, but aside from that, no liberty for you. And women. Let's not forget about women in liberty. You weren't allowed to vote. And if you were married, which you were expected to be, you only had as much liberty as your husband gave you. So I think we have to take the whole liberty thing with a grain of salt. Or maybe it's what we call ironic. But not like that Alanis Morissette song that our parents listen to, where nothing is ironic.
Anybody see anything we can use?
Pay for what you want.
It's better than nothing.
I wish we were in Dornley's room. He keeps the bats in his closet.
Oh, not in
his
closet. Not
with a gun in it.
Well, if it's locked.
Well, we'd be able to break the lock, obviously.
How do you break the lock?
Well, they could send out the code over the emergency system.
Okay, so we get the code, then what happens next?
Well, we'd
couple
figure
people said there's gunshots near there, but that was a few minutes ago. I know where that is.
What'd you say?
Stay quiet and listen.
We can figure it out. All I'm saying is your ass would be a lot safer right now.
I just want to make it out of this room today.
Please stop.
We can do it. There's a lot of stuff in front of the door. It'll probably just go through the ceiling.
Yeah, well, if he's got armor-piercing bullets, they're gonna go right through the table. Yeah. Look, if he comes in, I'm gonna tackle him.
What?
Yeah, but at least there'll be one less dumb redneck.
You're not a dumb redneck.
I was just gonna end up in the army anyway. And they're protecting your right to say crap I don't agree with, so. Might as well start now.
Right, his liver. With fava beans and a nice Chianti. That's from Silence of the Lambs. Hannibal Lecter, played by Anthony Hopkins. Sir, Anthony Hopkins. You probably know that fava beans come in pods. Or maybe you don't. Maybe you have no idea what a fava bean is. It's not like we've ever had them at home. I would use visual aids, but while it's bright enough in my head, in real life I'm in a janitor's closet in the dark. Fava beans look a little like longer, puffier pea pods, and green. but not the same green as peas. Then again, I'm color deficient, so what do I know? You have to take the beans out of the pot. Again, sort of like peas, but what a lot of people don't know is that they have a second skin. The woman at the farmer's market says it comes right off after you boil them. I don't know if this is true, but I'll peel these beans for you, even if it's not easy. For the piece de resistance, a fancy dinner should always be described in French, I'll be preparing seared scallops with king oyster mushrooms. The crazy thing about king oyster mushrooms is, if you saute them in a bit of butter with garlic, they taste exactly like scallops. So I'll be calling this dish scallops and scallops. Then of course there'll be the favas, which after I boil them, put them in an ice bath and remove the second skin, we sauteed in butter with a little garlic. You can have a Chianti with it if you want, though I think most experts would recommend a white wine. I'm gonna leave that one up to you. I'm also gonna chop up some parsley to sprinkle over the plate, because every plate should have some color. And I kinda wanted to try tarragon with the favas, but sometimes it's better to keep it simple. So, if I don't come home, Mom, this is the dinner I would have made you. I'm really sorry. Happy birthday.
Emergency response team is on the premises. Shooter's current location is unknown. Continue to shelter in place and send all updates to the emergency messaging system.
Jer, what? I have to go.
I know, we all want to go.
No! I have to go.
Now?
I was gonna go before, but then... What do I do?
Can you hold it? Like a couple minutes.
A couple?
Maybe 10 or 20?
I can't.
Okay, what if you go... What if you go in that corner over there?
Ew, no.
Well, can you hold it?
I told you I can't.
Well, those are the choices.
What about that closet?
I don't think the people hiding in there would like that very much.
But I really need to go.
Okay, I got you. Listen up, everybody. If you have to pee, go to that corner over there.
Oh, thank God.
Miss Rubin's got like a zillion beakers, so just borrow them. Well,
maybe we can label them and run tests on them.
Just lay low, as long as we don't hear anything in the hallway. And anybody who looks, I'll so call you out as a perv. Now who needs to go? Ellie, you first.
Hey! Hey, who's that?
Anthony.
Wade?
Johnson.
Oh, sorry. Drew? Hart, I got locked out of 207. Don't know why they tell us to come here if we get locked out. We can't lock the door. Can't hear the PA, and I got like one bar. How many of you got?
I don't know. Two.
Are you barking clear to me?
No, it's two.
No, no, somebody didn't flush. Oh. How do you drop this massive turd and not flush? Crap. Now it's all I can smell. Today just keeps getting better. You see anybody's stories?
This is my fault.
It's no, no, wait, what?
I caused this. This morning, I was getting ready, and I didn't mean any of the stuff I said. Not really. I mean, maybe some little part of me, but like the smallest little part, I never actually do it. Oh, God, now it's happened.
Wait. So you didn't hurt anybody, right?
I wish I never said it.
Dude, this isn't your fault.
Well, it is. Like, karma.
You're gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Okay.
Okay. If he comes in, I'm flipping this turd at him. Use what you got, right? Huh?
Hey!
Hey!
Are you okay?
Oh, it's not my blood. I'm not really sure whose it is.
Sorry, that was a stupid question.
Thank you for asking. If we don't make it out of this, I just wanted to say that I'm sorry.
For what?
For all the texts.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you didn't try to block me.
I did. 38 in one day is kind of my limit.
That's hilarious. Well, not hilarious, but funny. Not funny, haha, but funny weird, because that's exactly when I stopped at 38. Sorry for everything. My new therapist says that I should write you a letter so we can get out of this.
You don't have to write me a letter. I mean, you can write me a letter, but not for me. For you.
I'm not going to. I'm sorry I took this from you to say that I'm sorry. I bet Brian didn't send you 38 texts in one day.
Seriously?
I'm sorry. I'm just a little freaked out right now, so I'm a little more manic than usual.
I usually text him first.
Oh, well, he texts you back, right?
That's not your business.
No. I'm sorry. We should probably be quiet anyway if we could be the next announcement to come out of the job.
He doesn't really text a lot.
Well, he texted you today, right?
He texted me back. He's in history, 117. They're okay so far.
It's good. I texted you first.
I know.
I continue to look for you.
Please don't say that.
Okay.
I'm in the theater. The doors are locked and it's dark. I can see my friends. People I've been in classes with, done shows with, and done stupid fun, and occasionally embarrassing stuff with. My theater family. And my drama mom, Miss Dean, is an outline at the main door, which we bought for pieces of our set. These are my peeps. And I wouldn't want to be with anyone else right now. But I am. I'm surrounded by ghosts. The ghosts of all the kids who didn't get to grow up to be rock stars or poets or teachers, to dance like nobody's watching, tick off items on their bucket list, or come home. My ghosts with backpacks and math books and half-eaten grilled cheese sandwiches, still clutching their iPhones with the cracked screens, the jackets they wore no matter how hot it was, and the baseball gloves that never got broken in. Every moment it gets thicker and thicker, and it's getting harder to breathe. They're all around me, crowding to this row, and the next one, and the one after that, and soon I wonder if they'll be standing on each other's shoulders. And the floor, God, the floor, would it be strong enough to support all that weight? Or will we sink it to the ground to be swallowed? So many faces and names from so many places. And I think it's up to me to name angels like astronomers name stars. So if I make it out of my school today, I promise I'm gonna learn every name of every person who never did.
Somewhere?
It was crazy.
Yeah,
in there.
She could have dropped it easy.
I'm losing my freaking mind.
It's okay, my dude. We're gonna find her. I got Snap, you're on Insta. We got this. Hey people, we're looking for Talia, as in Talia and Tina, Tina and Talia. Hit us back if you're with her, you've seen her, you know where she is, or whatever. Muy importante.
Shooting at the school is all the thoughts and prayers you get after. My thoughts and prayers are with the victims of the Morning View High School shooting and their families. That's from one of our senators. My thoughts and prayers are with the victims of the Morning View High School shooting and their families. That's another senator. And the governor. Sending thoughts and prayers to hashtag Morning View High School. Random congressman in Montana. Gotta give him props for using a hashtag. Well, his intern probably wrote that. They all say the same thing. Thoughts and prayers, deeply saddened. Terrible tragedy, horrific tragedy, shocking tragedy. Not really sure why you're shocked, but... Okay. There's some hashtag never agains, and of course, lots of hashtag Morning View High School. Twelve of my friends and teachers are dead. And 19 more are in the hospital, including my friend Lionel, who was the fastest 800-meter runner in the state last year and had a track scholarship. But now, might not walk again. hour hashtag has been used 10,000 times in the past 12 hours, including by the president, 77 members of Congress, all the state legislators within 100 miles, 10 Academy Award winners, 21 Emmy winners, 15 Grammy winners, and 20 Tony Award winners. So, this then. I wonder if they'll still be using it tomorrow. Or the day after that. Or the day after that.
Hey, you're here!
I go rescue them from the driveway.
Hang on.
Shut up!
Wait, come on in, please! Shoot, I'm still the first one here. I swear I was driving around.
There are people in the kitchen. Mara's here!
Hey, what up, Mara?
Hey, you!
Oh, Lexi, I think James chipped your lamp.
James! Lexi, should I do that?
Oh, not if it's Lexi's parents.
Why would they ring their own doorbell?
Good point.
I will get it.
Cold. Okay.
Oh my god!
What are we eating today?
Huh? Greasy burger!
Let's go!
Let's do it.